Let's move on to the topic one, that is performance appraisal system. Performance appraisal system, all of us are actually, you know, very eagerly wait for. At the same time, you know, if it is not a good result, then it will be a very, very bitter experience for all of us. So actually, you know, HR department recruits, select the candidate, induct them, provide them a training, and after training has been provided, you know, employees have been put onto the job. And when an employee has been put onto the job, at the end of, let's say, one particular period or a cycle, we try to, you know, evaluate whether the employee has done a good job or not. We need to rate it. That's what exactly performance appraisal system is all about. So in a simple sentence, according to a Flippo, it's a nothing but a prominent personality in the field of a human resource. Actually, he says that performance appraisal is a systematic, periodic, and an impartial kind of a rating of an employee excellence in the matters pertaining to his present job and the potential for a better job. So he might be, some of the employee might be doing extremely good compared to the present position. He might be, you know, suitable for the higher kind of a position also. So that also we need to consider here. And at the same time, you know, the people who are doing a good job, we need to recognize them. And this is the way actually, you know, we try to look at how each people or, you know, employees contributing for the organization. That we'll come to know through this performance appraisal system. And now let's try to look at it. Why do we require this performance evaluation? If you look at the performance evaluation, this actually, you know, it is basically one to review the past performance of an employee. Because if we don't know the past performance of an employee, we may not be able to treat them, we may not be able to provide the right kind of, you know, consideration. So important decision makings, we'll come to know that how is the contribution of the particular employee towards an organization, that we'll come to know through this particular performance evaluations. And the next thing is actually, you know, it's a way through which we establish a line of communication with the employer and an employee through which we try to, you know, communicate to them what is right and what is wrong. And the next one is we create an opportunity to discuss professional development goals and objectives. We try to, you know, look at it, what exactly is expected out of the job and how exactly, you know, the employee is supposed to perform and what are the kind of, you know, outcomes are looking at. And these are the kind of, you know, expectations we can set. And we can document the employee performance in the form of certain kind of, you know, parameter, and we can give the weightage for that, and based on that, you know, we can go ahead. And other than that, you know, we can take a corrective kind of an action necessary to improve the work performance, because sometime, you know, what happens is like employee may not know, he may, it might be going in the different directions. So we can able to document the corrective kind of an actions. And it is a supervisor's and manager's responsibility to monitor and evaluate and then coach employees. And these are the ways actually, you know, the performance evaluation can direct the person in the right kind of, you know, way, so that, you know, best kind of an output can be brought out. So now let's try to look at the performance, you know, purpose of a performance appraisal. It is basically to review the performance of an employee and to judge the gap between actual and the desired performance. Organization might have certain kind of, you know, desired performance, but we look at it actually, you know, what is the employee's performance, where is the gap, so that we can find out. And the next one is to, it will help the management in exercising and, you know, organization control as to what is expected out of it. And you know, sometimes when there is a deviation happens in the department or individual, you know, completely from organization goal, we can able to, you know, probably put them into a right track, so that, you know, we can have a complete organization control. And other thing is to diagnose the training and development needs of the future. When we talk about training and development needs of the future, we are talking about what is the kind of a training is required, which are the areas there is a, you know, lack of skills, and how we are going to, you know, probably manage all these things. These are the things we might be able to diagnose, and we might provide an information to assist in the HR decisions, like which employee has to be provided in promotion and who has to be provided in transfer, and which are the kind of people we can consider for the next kind of post. All this kind of, you know, internal transfer decisions and all, we can able to take it with the help of this performance appraisal. And it's provide a complete clarity of the expectations and responsibilities, and what is actually, you know, the function expected out of it, and what exactly employee has to perform. All this detail we will get out of it, and we can able to judge the effectiveness of the other human resource functions. If we reduce the grievances of the employee, and ultimately helps the, you know, helps to strengthen the relationship and communication between superior subordinate and management. That's the way actually, you know, employees can get a lot of kind of an opportunity to, you know, probably talk talk out, and then they can establish a communication. We can change the systems. It acts as a kind of feedback for the organization as well as for the employee. So it is not only, you know, reviewing about only the employee, but also the overall organization review of performance happens through this performance appraisal system. And if you look at it, actually, you know, by using the performance appraisal system, which are the areas, you know, it will be helpful. It will help in raising the particular individual to a next level. We look at the merit of each case, and then, you know, we can, you know, decide that which employee has to be provided more salary, pay, bonuses, and all these calculations, decisions, we can able to take it. And the next thing is actually, you know, personal decisions, like who has to be promoted, who has to be transferred, and who, which employee has to be dismissed, and any kind of, you know, other disciplinary actions has to be taken. So that can be taken based on this particular performance appraisal. And third one is identification of a training needs can be done through the performance appraisal. So by doing a performance appraisal, we'll come to know that, you know, in certain areas, certain employee might be, you know, underplaying or probably underperforming. So by looking at that underperforming, we can try to analyze that, why is the reason. So there could be a skill gap. In order to fill that particular skill gap, we can come out with certain kind of training programs. And ultimately, you know, this performance appraisal also helps in research and understanding that how an HR is supposed to function, how an organization is supposed to function, so that we can able to bring the best out of it. So these are the kind of reasons actually performance appraisal systems have been commonly followed.